This is one humongous base. Okay, it was that one making the noise. Oh shit! There's Clint! Scared the hell out of me, man! Shit, 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 that weapon. I don't like this fire around me. I can't, it's so hard to aim. Oh, wow. Okay. Am I stuck somewhere? No. No, you are pissing me off, man. So let's do one of these. Stop shooting me with that mist thing I can't see through. Okay. His arm. Okay, I will just keep on shooting where the beams are coming from. Okay, he's down.
Hey, toss anything you can't haul my way.
B-51E. Old man sunglasses. Well, I will most certainly take that. That hat is nice. CP. I don't know about that. How much those weight? Can still carry that. Okay, so that was the last one. Last of the three big guys I've seen. Holy shit, this place is... Oh wow, this was crazy. This was crazy. They have all these terminals I have just been passing through.
Nice. Oh,
hello. Critical damage, nice. One shotgun shell. Suppressed calibrated powerful combat shotgun, maybe? Okay, there was still one more there. Is this some sort of a main base for the gunners or something? Now that's what I'm talking about. Sneak attack. Oh, I was planning on taking the fusion core out when it's nearly out to hello. When it's just in 1%.
I don't think we're alone.
I can see a frag mine from all the way in here. The plasma mine. There's a turret. That is pretty awesome. A turret in a shopping cart. Just using bats here to check what I can see. Right. Now there's the whole exploring of this place. Let's see about these terminals. Yeah, shopping turrets. Well said. Oh, wow. Oh, wow, wow. Lieutenant Clint signed in. Personal logs. Colonel Hollis. Shame I couldn't convince Colonel Hollis to see reason, but the attack plan worked all the same. Once we blew the support on the highway and took the high ground, there's nothing they could do. Garvey managed to escape with a group of the settlers, but the rest was just a bloodbath. I had them capture Colonel Hollis alive so I could prove them, my new troops, that I'm done with the Minutemen. Even when I put the barrel to his head, he still refused to see that this is just how the world works. If you want to bring order to the chaos, you need strength to do it. The Minutemen don't have it anymore, the Gunners do. Captain Wes assured me that the troops he's given me in exchange for breaking the siege will obey the chain of command, but two of the more senior troops are proving difficult. Preston. The detachment I sent after Garvey returned yesterday. They managed to pick off several more of the settlers before losing them in Jamaica Plains. Tessa is complaining that we let some of them get away, but she's still thinking like a raider. The Minutemen are done. Colonel Hollis was the last leader they had of any worth, and Preston certainly isn't going to be leading a counterattack with a bunch of wounded women and children. Interesting. Tessa and Baker. We have gotten our main camp set up on the freeway here, so we can't be taken the way the Minutemen were. I managed to get a radio tied into an old tower to establish contact with GNN. Tessa and Baker had a long talk with Captain Wes, while Baker has fallen into line. Tessa seems to be even more subordinate. Now that we're pretty well established and the troops are done setting up camp, I'm going to have to find other work for them to do. If they're busy, Tessa won't have time to rile them up. Maybe if I can keep her out of camp for a while, for others will follow Baker's lead and stop questioning my commands. Captain Wes also said to check with the medic to get my blood type tattooed. Seems unnecessary, but if the Chester will convince them, it's probably worth a bit of pain. Okay, looks like something more there. Hello, Maldini. How you doing? There was something more there. Intel. Quarry. I sent some scouts down the highway to check any other nearby threats, but the only thing nearby seems to be the quarry up at the inlet. Looks to be a group of raiders, but with a good sniping position on the freeway, they wouldn't dare try to start the fight with us. Baker fired off a few rockets down at them, nothing major, just to make sure they know what they're dealing with. The factory. I sent Tessa out with a squad to scout to the south, mostly to get her out of my hair for a while. They reported that there's not much there in the marsh other than an old factory. Looks to be inhabited by the Greenskins. They might cause a problem eventually, but for now, I don't think we need to pick fight when we have got prisoners to deal with. Atom Cats. Turns out there's a group living at the garage out on the peninsula. They call themselves the Atom Cats, and they seem to be a pretty tight crew. The scouts have reported that their external fortifications are fairly weak, but they have several suits of power armor. Normally I'd say it isn't worth the trouble, but with the troops angry about losing the prisoners, it might be the distraction they need. So it looks like I have taken out the main gunner forces. Thanks for that. Replacement for one of the mini nukes. Yeah, I have taken out main parts of the gunners. Because I took care of Wes already, and now these three. So we should be in a pretty good spot. Is it something about letting them capture Colonel Hollis? Hollis. this doesn't ring a bell. Careful in there. Oh! Mama Murphy's note. Oh, now I get it. Okay, I thought they had just the Gunners captured the Minutemen. And then they escaped, but they were here and these guys drove them away. Is that it? I sent Sturgis to talk to Mayor Jackson about what I saw with the site. I mixed up another cocktail and I can feel it starting to take hold. Wanna see if getting the mayor to call for help changes the vision. Sturgis and Jackson have been get me to stop using. Going to need the site again if we're gonna make it through this. What was that about the doggy? Did you see a dog somewhere? I didn't. Mama Mervis, no, wait, I was here already. Yes. Picture of a dog. Right, okay. I will really have to look through this place carefully. Mama Murphy's stash. I wonder if you would eventually get a mission from the Minutemen. Deal with this place. This looks like their store. Duct tapes are the most important ones. Three of them. Weapons workbench. Some stash arenos. Mining helmet, that's nice. Oh, that looks nice. That's an awesome looking helmet for some of the settlers, maybe. Surveyor.
Anything I can lug for you?
Easy guard helm. Yeah, I don't have too many of those either. Can't pick up the head. Nice. Mining helmet, sunglasses. Sure if I have the greaser stuff. Don't have that kind of baseball cap either.
Hey, lend you a hand with that terminal? All you gotta do is ask.
Hey.
I'm listening.
I will first give you some stuff. Let you take those. Nice, nice mining helmets, I like those. These don't actually weigh anything on when they are broken. That's interesting. So that's why I can actually carry quite a lot of stuff here.
Hey.
I'll see what I can do.
Wait there.
I'll stay.
No.
Think you can unlock that terminal?
Count on it.
Okay.
Well, well. Shabby set of protocols. Bingo.
Bingo, bango, bongo.
Hey.
I'm all ears.
You following me now? Maybe this is for the Tourette or something. There's a safe somewhere? Okay. did not yet... Oh. There it is. Did not actually see the safe before I noticed that one. This place is so huge. Generator. Guess I could actually... Could I build a base here or something? Yes, I could. Where did I see those terminals? Of course, anyone who has played a... Fallout New Vegas is going to say bingo bango bongo. Yeah, here it is. Hollis's terminal. Can't do that while... You mean I can't sit down? Unbelievable. Fine. Hello, Idiavi. Colonel Hollis. Setting up defenses. Looks like we got here just in time. We ended up taking a group of gunners from behind as we came into town. Took about a third, but at least a dozen ran off. Major Jackson was practically in tears when we came up. Ah, now I remember this Quincy. Preston was talking about this. Yeah. Took about a third, but at least a dozen ran off. Major Jackson was practically in tears when we came up. Even let us use his own house as a barracks. Gotta say, it's nice to find the Minutemen welcomed like we were back in the old days for a change. Preston has been helping them get some better walls up, but the town mechanic has been invaluable. He even has a couple of suits of power armor. If he can get them up and running, it'd be a huge help. We don't have near enough manpower to hold the town if the gunners return in force, but I can't tell anyone that. I sent out a word to try to get reinforcements from any other Minutemen out there. I hope at least Colonel Morbury will be willing to help. I've totally forgotten everything about the Minutemen stuff at the beginning of the game. This probably makes quite a lot of sense, all this. We've gotten the walls in pretty good shape and filled the stairwell at the monorail platform. I've had Sturges working on getting some walkways set up across the rooftops. Figure if they manage to breach the wall, we may be able to retreat up there for a counterattack. The gunners attack almost daily now, but we have got food and supplies enough that we can probably wait them out. Unfortunately, my call for reinforcements has been disappointing. Not a single person has shown up. Betrayed. Today has been a terrible turn of events. One of our own, 10-year veteran named Clint, showed up at the gate. I thought at first he had come to tell us reinforcements were on the way, but it turns out the bastard has changed sides. He's apparently leading this group of gunners who have been laying siege. He actually had the nerve to try to convince the mayor and me to stand down. I politely informed him that there was not a chance in hell that of that happening, and that I would do his traitorous ass if he... What I would do to his traitorous ass if he showed up again. If someone of his experience is leading them, we better be ready for anything. I think I've checked this building completely. So then let's check this one out. Don't see much here. This one is in more ruins than the other places. Ah, the turret was here. Okay. So then that is checked. There's no way into this building. There was the gun store. There's a bar. Here. Okay. Where you want money? Chemistry station. Terminal. What do we have here? It's interesting. I can use this with the power armor, but not Hollis's terminal. There was nothing there, but to maybe check holotape if I want to. This was a back door. There's actually that way the police station I was looking for, but let's continue checking this place out. So what do we have here? Can't go in there. Some sort of tower. I didn't even notice they had a... Wait, is this the... Is this where I had the mama? Ah. Right, but I came from the other side, right? Settler chose his own faith. Oh, had to release that. Nice. Okay, that's good. Actually, let's take the square on a stick. Shim, how are you doing? How are you doing? Way out from there, alright. Alright, the Dark Souls video is already up. Probably people seeing the notification on YouTube. Oh, grenade. That's a normal thing to have under counter. Yes. This is where they were holding their prisoners, I assume. Yes, this is the place where I attacked at the beginning. Sturgis Terminal? I'm doing good, Shibishi. Thanks for asking. Okay. Sturgis Garage. Interesting. I was out visiting some friends of mine down at the Atom Cat's garage earlier, and they hooked me up with a sweet deal on a couple suits of power armor. They're in a rough shape, but nothing I can't fix up. We had to track that one back here, since it won't start up at the moment, even with the fresh fusion core. Okay, so then Tessa and Clint. No, they actually all had power armors, right? Yeah, no, Clint and Tessa, Baker didn't. So these are the two power armors they are talking about. We had to track that one back here. This won't start up at the moment, even with the fresh fusion core. I gotta find some way to thank Fenton for helping me out with that. Maybe I can pay off his tab at the hole in the wall. Well, maybe part of his tab anyway. Mama Murphy's vision. I don't like this. Mama Murphy's been holed up in her room since that traitor came through. She got a fresh stash of gems and I went to make sure she's eating something. She said she's been having the sight again. Said she saw the town surrounded and overrun. How people dead in the streets or captured. It sounds crazy, but she's been right about things before and we were able to convince Jackson to put out a call for the Minutemen. I just hope it's not too late. Right, yeah. Yeah, this is where it all started. Colonel Hollis rolled in with the Minutemen yesterday. Man, did they ever get here in nick of time. So Sturgis was not with the Minutemen. Sturgis was just here in this town. Took those gunners from behind and had them running for the hills. Mars has been making a fuss about how few showed up, but the colonel has been assured us that others will come. In the meantime, Preston has been helping Sloan and me reinforce the walls. Shame that power armor is on the fridge again. Sure would be a help on carrying all that lumber. Or actually, were they part of the Minutemen already because Preston was here? I don't know. Baker. Sergeant Baker here. Looks like this terminal is still working. Quite the setup that Grease Monkey's got here. I'm impressed how well Clint's plan worked. Guess I should say Lieutenant Clint. After he blew out the support, we were able to rush onto the highway itself. With the cover of darkness and the height advantage, we had things wrapped up in under an hour. A group of them managed to slip away. Good thing the lieutenant sent the detachment after them, or Tessa may have broken ranks and done it herself. Maybe if we can get these suits of power armor back in order, it'll convince her to cool it. Well, it took me about an hour to take them down as well, so guess it's all cool. Let's see if we... What was that? I was thinking if I could find something Sturgis left behind. I have been playing some console games, but I only have Xbox 360 at the moment. I'm mostly a PC gamer, simply because it's so much easier for me to PC gamer as far as doing any videos goes, because it's so much easier for me to stream or record. Okay, what do we have here? Back safe at least. And I think I can open this with my new expert skills. Always try so hard and eventually it's almost straight up the bin. It actually works. We'll not be playing the new Doom, no. Not my type of game, as far as streaming or let's playing goes. Not going to play it. There's so many games I want to play that I just can't play them all, and basically just have to rule some out. Okay, this is right, so here was another way. Not a way in here. Then up there I was. Yeah, I think Nick, we are done here. I'm probably not going to play the Doom anytime soon. I said I have quite a lot of games to play, so I'm not even going to play it. I think before I leave and have another go, we'll actually check the Quincy police station. Open a door here or something. Ah, this is the police station. Was not on this side before. Ooh. That was well hidden fusion core there. But not well hidden enough. Police terminals. Telephone. Oh! See you later, Eliavi. Lockup. I wonder if they still have someone here. Wonder if this police robot will somehow activate. Spooky place. So this is what I came here for the Eddie Winter holotapes. Protector and control, remote door control. Let's open that. Tucker homicide logs. Trespassing. Arnie A's interment cemetery. One shovel. Oh, I was in the cemetery digging graves. Okay, I opened that one, I think. Alright, here's Eddie Winters. So where is it? Received Officer Hart, Quincy PD. Mailed to Officer Doyle, South Boston, in possession of Commonwealth Coast Guard. There must be some tape around. Will Devil Lighter Floyd. Bags contained remains of charred leaves. Recovered at scene. Please don't. Ah, I can't use these terminals. Want to see about protector and control. Let's put the subway steward on. I have a subway ticket.
Powering up, Protectron on duty.
Ah, thanks, quest pointer. That was pretty well hidden there in the dark. Might have pretty easily missed that. I think I opened this this path here. Someone trying to...
Inside, you got, well, now we know where they store their ammo.
Do we? Someone trying to escape through this? That's interesting. I don't see any ammo, Nick. What were you talking about? Oh, another patrolman sunglasses. What was the purpose of this, Oh! I didn't know they actually do that. The Protectron actually left the basement. I was like, what's the purpose of the Protectron if it just stays down there? This could have been the distraction for, could have been a little distraction for the Gunners. Alright, what's on Eddie Winter's tape? That's the next question. What number was it? I have no idea. Was it 9?
Message to Claire Pazinski. Time to start thinking about a vacation. How does 6 weeks in Ireland sound to you? Dublin, Galway Bay, Waterford. Maybe a week in that little bed and breakfast in Kilkenny. And don't worry.
I remember this.
I'll take my cousin Stephen with us. Let him get out of the country on his own.
There's the Adam Getz garage.
Not blast him in the face with a shotgun.
But there's the...
rotten that abandoned fishery down in Union Wharf for all I care.
There's the South Boston Police Department. I'm looking for
Eddie Winter, signing off.
Was it free?
Message to Robert Cooper. Bobby, we discussed this. You hooking up with your stepsister is your own friggin' business. But you talk in your sleep. Look, maybe you babble about baseball or sing show tunes. Or could be you chat about those three bodies Colin O'Malley dumped in the sand trap of Arlington Greens. You want to take that chance? I know I don't. Sorry, Robert. The girl's gotta go. Eddie Winter, signing off.
I think I will listen to all of
your
the tapes.
Your pip-boy doesn't sound pleased. Let's say we get out of here.
Oh, that's not what I wanted. Oh, man. Okay, what do we have here? Shit.
I didn't think I could still get them.
Okay. Rifle still beat... rifle still beat big guns. For me, at least. Yeah, I will listen to all of the Eddie's tapes when I get them all. Shit. Not alright. I think what I need to do is get my weapons back up to normal. So, assault rifle 2. Boomstick 3, 6, oh, that's 5, that is 6, that is 4, oh, it actually takes them, oh, never mind, if you reassign them, you actually take them out from there.
Bad. That's it.
Holy shit. That's a lot of stuff. Still have the carrying capacity for those. So where does this lead me then? Ah, just around, okay. And yeah, this place I do remember. Didn't remember it was so radiated. I think it's time for us to visit home for a change and unload the stuff and then return for the next tape. Store all the junk. Store that. Suppressed combat shotgun. That's actually a pretty interesting one. Then all these. So that one. Leave these here. Maybe I'll give the sunglasses to the settlers here. That was the fist weapon. Okay, let's repair this thing first. Ask Nick.
Heads up.
Take these. I think Nick is out of ammo as well. Luckily, I've been finding some more.
Something for you?
Oh, wait. I could put some magazines in here. So, wait a minute, I can... I think I have some grognacks. Yes, grognacks and guns and bullets. Else. Robco fun, I guess. Haven't built this Tesla science. Okay, it's full. Nice. Look at all those grognacks. Wasteland Survival Guide. Couple of versions of them, nice. Excellent.
What are you building?
I'm repairing. So, steel. Yeah. So expensive. There was one expensive attack, that one. I'm not going to repair that chest. Special chest. The special chest didn't take that much damage. Interestingly. Then these things here. Now.
If you ain't been up to see Grey Garden, you should go. Whole place is run by robots.
I know.
Just wanted to trade a few things.
Sure thing.
So I've been giving you an army helmet. What we give you? Some sunglasses. So why don't you take that one? So, meet that. Those on. Oh, okay. You can only use the helmets. Yeah, use the helmets. Let's take that for me. Yep, that'll do. The Sturge is waiting. Right, that guy already had it. What I was actually thinking was to give the mining helmets to the mining helmet, the Spiper. Mining helmets to the to those who go between the bases. Wait, there's still a whole lot of stuff I didn't leave behind. Ah, right, I'm still carrying all them. Right. Carrying all the big weapons. Let's see if I can find those guys who are traveling between the sites. So let's leave a fat man here. Yeah, I guess I will just leave all these. The shredding one. Okay. Before I go find more idiots,
I can barely tell us apart.
Let's visit the bases and see if I can find a. Find some of those who are taking the things between the bases. Provisioners, I think they are called. Actually, haven't been here. Been here that many times. Seems to be all right. Actually, there it is. Sunshine Tidings. It's a different icon. I haven't been here in a while. Is that actually one of the provisioners?
Yeah?
Yes, you are.
Can we trade a few things?
Sure.
Yeah, I wanted to give you mining helmets and sunglasses. Can you wear it? Mining helmets and then the sunglasses. There we go. Wait a minute, that one doesn't have a light on it. Wait.
Let's trade.
Of course.
Thought all the mining helmets actually have a light. Hmm. That is strange. It looks like it has a light, but it doesn't really have one. Look at the difference, I think. No, that's different color. Do I need to attach a light to it? Do it actually have a light? It's a bit annoying that that icon actually shows that it has a light. Does that actually work? Because my idea is that they would actually have lights when they are going around. Let me see. Do I need to actually put the light there myself? Right, they didn't have a...
You stumble into a library?
They didn't have a... Armor station there.
Easy living, this
is. It?
Nothing I hate more than raider scumbags. If you run into any, put a few down for me.
I'll try to make myself useful.
Mining headlamp. It actually has that.
No one will
okay.
Grown
that's
man feeling sorry for himself.
We can change the color. Huh. That's pretty interesting. So if I wear it, it will work, right? Yeah, there's a light. Why didn't that show up on that other guy? I don't know. So let's go hunt some cops again. So we have at least one clue. Alright. We have a more tapes there, so the Nahant Sheriff Department, and then we have the South Boston one. There's the Jamaica plane that was mentioned a couple of times, so let's go see about that. There's something, some more information and stories about the Minutemen, Preston and others. So Jamaica plane is... Looks like it's the Brotherhood fighting again.
Hey, this is Jamaica Plain. Stay sharp. A lot of raiders end up here looking for that lost treasure.
Lost treasure, eh? Let's see about that. Cool.
Something out there.
Oh, nice two shots.
So long, pal. One way to get coolant pumping.
That was some good shooting, even if I say so myself. Yeah, looks like we will have a little bit more action here. Saw another one there. Again, sneaking in my power armor. Oh, hello. That was not good. That was not good shooting.
When I thought we were getting along.
Nick took care of it. Nice. Nick!
Someone's coming.
I know.
What's that?
Shit!
You're in for it now!
Alright, see you later. Probably not going to stream that long, but
your funeral. Anyone you walk away from.
Yeah, I guess this. Oh, where did I pick up the ladder? I have no idea. Are you stuck there or something? So refreshing to actually be able to kill something. It's relatively easy. That's one broken up statue right there.
What's that? Someone's coming.
Not anymore. At least from that side.
Watching a conductor at the orchestra.
Another useless door. Ah, random plasma. That's book.
Sure any, made a mess of this place, didn't they?
Any unreturned books? Ah, wall safe. Oops, almost got it right there. Almost straight up, but not quite.
Yes.
Okay, I think it was straight up, actually.